Hello, today we're going to go over setting up the ServiceNow Smart Connector inside of Enterprise Alert to talk to the ServiceNow system. So first step we're going to want to do is go ahead and click on your system, and we are going to add a new event source, and click on the new source button at the bottom, and then we are going to choose the ServiceNow option in the drop-down. This is going to load up the ServiceNow connector. Now, we're not quite ready to set this information up yet, but what we do need is to download this update set here on the right. So we right-click and save the file, and we're going to save that to a folder on your computer where you know and have access to. Once that file is downloaded, we are going to want to go ahead and switch over to your ServiceNow instance. And then we have to import that downloaded XML into the ServiceNow instance. So in order to do that, on the left-hand side, scroll all the way down till you get to an option for System Update Sets. Expand that option out, and you'll see a Retrieved Update Sets option. Click on this, and inside of here, you'll have an option to import update sets from XML. So if we click on that button, and then we click on the Choose File button, and then choose the downloaded XML that you from the folder you put it in, and click on the Open button. And then from there, you're going to want to click on the Upload. You'll now see the Enterprise Alert XML with the state of loaded. Once that's in there, click on the Enterprise Alert, and on the top right-hand side, you'll see a button that says Commit Update Set. We don't see it on this screen because I've already downloaded and committed my set. Once you see on that button, though, click on the Commit Update Set, and that will, it'll load the update set into the system and ready it for use inside of ServiceNow. So if we go back into Local Update Sets, we'll now see Enterprise Alert with a complete status inside of this system. Once that is done, we now need to create a new user that Enterprise Alert can use when talking back and forth with the ServiceNow system. So we need to go into User Admin and click on the Users option, and then we're going to click on the New User button. Inside here, we need to give it a user ID. I'm going to call mine EA Admin, and a first name of EA Admin, just so it makes it a little bit user, last name user. It doesn't matter, you can give it whatever title or department that you want to give it, but they are mandatory fields, so you need to put something in there. You can set the password to your liking. Just make sure you keep track of both the user ID and the password, because you'll need that inside the Enterprise Alert ServiceNow setup. Once the user is all set up, go ahead and click on the Submit button, and we've created our new user. Now we need to find the user that we just created and open up the user to edit them. And we need to add that user to a couple of roles. So click on the Roles tab. So from the Roles tab, click on the Edit button. And on this edit screen, we're going to add a list of a couple of roles to this user. On this page, we need to add a list of certain roles, and the list of the roles are as follows: the ITIL, the ITIL underscore admin, the REST underscore service, the template underscore editor, the U underscore enterprise underscore alert underscore new underscore incidents underscore user, and the view underscore changer roles. Once all of those roles are in the right-hand box, click on the Save button at the bottom, and that'll add all of our rights and roles to this new Enterprise Alert user. Once we have all this information, we now need to head back over to the Enterprise Alert service, and inside of our ServiceNow connector, we're going to fill in the information at this point. So you need to give it a name. Choose any name that makes it easily identifiable for you to let you know that it is an event source for incoming ServiceNow events. You then need to enter the web service URL that allows you to connect to your ServiceNow instance. Once the web service URL is set, you're going to keep the integration mode to import set to the recommended, enter in your username and password. From there, you can change the options at the bottom. The first option, Set Assigned To, allows you to assign the ticket inside of ServiceNow to whoever acknowledges or closes the alert inside of Enterprise Alert. The second option says, when somebody acknowledges an alert for a ticket from ServiceNow, it'll automatically set the ticket to the active state. And when somebody closes an alert inside of Enterprise Alert that is started from a ticket for ServiceNow, it'll set the incident to resolved state inside of ServiceNow. So we're going to check both of those, and then we're going to click on the Save button. Once you click on the Save button, you'll be brought back to the Event Sources home screen, and you'll see your new connection in that screen. The connection will take a second to load, and once it finishes loading, if it shows a blue OK, then it has connected to the ServiceNow instance and is ready to receive events. If it shows an orange with an error or a please wait, then it is having trouble connecting to that server and needs still some correction made to it, such as the URL, or maybe the username and password is incorrect, something in our setup was incorrect. So at this point, if we were to head back into our ServiceNow and create a new incident, all right, so once this incident's created, we can go back into our Enterprise Alert, and if we go to the Alerts tab and the incoming events, we will see a new ServiceNow connection event. And from here, if we click on this Create Policy from Event, you can create a new alert policy for any incoming events that meet the criteria we set here. So for now, I'm just going to set up a quick alert policy to take any incoming events from ServiceNow, as long as it's a new event, and create an event to send to my user. Just going to do a quick email for my guy. On this message screen, you can enter any alert subject and text that allows you to know exactly what the alert's coming through. You can use any of the parameters that came over from ServiceNow inside the ticket to allow some dynamic material inside the ticket so your users can get the information that they need. For now, I'm just creating a quick and simple alert so that we see the alerts come through. So I'm going to save and close that. Now I'm going to go back into ServiceNow and create a new ticket just so we can see this come through and create an Enterprise Alert alert. So here we are, and we'll see there's my new event, and you'll see now that it triggered my alert that I just created for the ServiceNow events. And if I go back into my Alert Center, we'll see that I now have an alert, and it is emailing my user. And that's how you get ServiceNow to start sending alerts for new tickets through the Enterprise Alert system and to your users. Thank you and have a nice day.